Who, if I cried out, would hear me among the angelic orders? And even if one were to suddenly take me to its heart, I would vanish into its stronger existence. For beauty is nothing but the beginning of terror, that we are still able to bear, and we revere it so, because it calmly disdains to destroy us. Every angel is terror. Reina Maria Rilke, Duino Elgis. Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mildred, and I'll be your gaming monk for the evening. Now, we've tackled plenty of genres within the history of this illustrious temple. Fantasy, science fiction, wuxia, post-apocalyptic, anime. But one we really haven't tackled as much is urban fantasy. It's a simple affair. You take the modern world and sprinkle a little bit of the unreal. Typically, there's some element of noir insofar as it's being set in a specific city, even if that city isn't named. Within it, the supernatural is hidden to all but those who can see the world as it is. After all, the best place to hide is in plain sight. Enter Relics, A Game of Angels. A tale of angels who struggle with a sudden lack of guidance, being cut off from heaven for reasons unknown. Using the fugue system from Alice Vegas, which hopefully I'll get to sometime in the future, and using a tarot card-based setup. How does it hold up? Well, let's find out. Relics runs at 314 pages and is very clearly taking some inspirational notes from the world of darkness, opening with a lengthy piece of fiction in the first 14 pages and jumping between different places. That said, I think the font is a bit thin on the regular text, along with the white background. I could see it blending in for some eyes. On the flip side, I do enjoy the use of black and white art throughout, giving off the feel of a 90s indie comic with the use of negative space. Unfortunately, not only is there a lack of an index, but in the PDF version there is a severe lack of bookmarks. There's some chapter hyperlinks within the table of contents, but that only works so well. C'est la vie. Character creation is an 8-step process, and we'll be exploring this with an angel named Gaghiel. The first step is Signifier. This is a special card within Relic's tarot setup, where if it's drawn during play, you may gain a triumphant success. This is drawn randomly from the Major Arcana, with a redraw if we draw the Devil or the World, because those have their own set of rules. In our case, we drew Justice, the 11th Major Arcana. Step 2 is Aspect. Aspects are the core essence of an angel that's associated with what they were built to do. Each of these is associated with one of the Minor Arcana suits, and has a miracle associated with it. In our case, we'll go with Nesher as our aspect. This is the eagle-faced angel and master of movement, associated with the suit of coins. This also means that we start with the Wings of Heaven miracle. While all angels can fly, in our case we can outfly any non-Nesher, and we have two blessings on flying tests. Step 3 is Herald, the early progenitor of angels that we have an association with. In our case, we have Chazakiel as our herald, meaning that we have dominion over lightning. Step 4 is the Descent. Effectively, this is the answer to why the angel left heaven and came to earth. This is a narrative step instead of a mechanical one, but in our case, Gaghiel was just a restless spirit. Step 5 is Mission. This is a loose reflection of the angel's philosophy on the human question, or rather, what they're supposed to be doing on earth, and these became factions unto themselves. In our case, we'll go with the Armor of Righteousness, also known as the Armorers. This mission believes that angels should be working with humanity, teaching by example and acting as champions of virtue. Step 6 is Relic, Dominions, and First Miracle. Effectively, this is where we determine the powers they have by being angels. The first is Miracles, the power to shape creation to their will. Second is Dominion, an element of creation that they can command. And third is Relic, an item that contains the powers of miracles, once locked away but now reactivated by God's absence. We'll start with one dominion from our herald, and one miracle along with the nature of the relic that contains them. As mentioned before, we have the lightning dominion, and subsequently control over the sky, potentially because we're still starting out as an angel. As for miracle effects, these are rooted in level and trammel. the former being the strength of the effect, and the latter is the restriction of the miracle. In our case, we'll go with Weather Flash as our miracle, which allows for the creation of small atmospheric effects once per scene. The relic we'll use is a compass that he keeps with him. Step 7 is Descriptive Touches. This step concerns more of the narrativist part in creation. This includes when they arrived on Earth, their contribution as an angel before arriving, their impact on human history, their appearance, a mark, which is a telltale sign for them, and mortal connection. Step 8 is Memory, which is the skill system of sorts. Because the angels don't learn from repetition like humans do, they have to recall the experience when they learned it in the past. This is done typically in a roundtable style with the other players, but since that doesn't work for this example, we'll be skipping this phase. Character creation is apropos for a narrativist game, with my only critique being the lack of a summary version of each step. Most of the creation chapter is self-contained with the exception of powers, and I think the possibility of using random draws for each step gives a nice kick to the process. My only issue is that the memory part asks for a specifics placed out at the table. See, it's operating on the notion of everyone coming to the table blank instead of setting up their characters in advance. Half of character creation can be done in advance, but not memories. Ultimately, a whole lot of good with a couple potential nitpicks, depending on your table's style. Relics uses a card-based system through the tarot deck. This is accomplished via a degrees of success-like system with its tests. When making a test, you draw a single card from the deck and interpret its results. A minor arcana of 1 to 6 is a failure, while a 7 to 10 is a grudging success, i.e., you succeed, but a court card, i.e., king, queen, knight, page, is a full success, i.e., you succeed, and while major arcana draws are typically treated as full successes, with three exceptions. If you draw the devil, you have a no-and type of failure. If you draw the world, you gain a dramatic success, one step higher than a full success. If you draw the major arcana that matches your signifier, you also gain a dramatic success, but you gain a new miracle as well. Furthermore, an angel's aspect grants them a mastery, which activates when taking an action related to said mastery and drawing a suit that matches the angel's aspect. When this happens, that draw is treated as a full success regardless of the card's value. For example, the Isha aspect means that any cups drawn while taking an action related to speaking qualify as a full success. Relics also possesses an advantage-disadvantage system called Blessings and Blights. If an action grants either, you draw an extra card based on the amount of either and take the highest or the lowest result, respectively. The most common use of this is through skills, which grant their own blessing, but there are other means. However, activating memories costs one of the chips that the GM places at the table at the start of each session. Usually there will be 7 of these. I would be remiss if I didn't mention the complex test, since it operates on a different set of rules. Essentially, it's a game of blackjack, minus insurance, double down, etc., where you're using your hand to beat the GM's hand while not getting over 21. If you simply beat the dealer, you gain a grudging success. If you get to 21 in at least 3 cards, you get a full success, with an extra degree if you manage to do it in 2 cards. It should be noted that court cards of the minor arcana count as 10, aces can be low or high, i.e. either a 1 or an 11, and mastery cards count as 1 if the action qualifies. Major arcana count as either 10 or the number on the arcana card, i.e. the tower could be played as a 10 or a 16. Lastly, your signifier is treated as a 2-card 21. I do like the tarot system present, and while it's a nice gesture that the game has a 2d6 alternative for those who don't feel like using a deck, it's clear that Relic is meant to be played with that tarot deck. I have a mixed attitude about the signifier being one of the primary means of gaining new miracles, since that's pretty low odds. It's a tightrope to walk regardless, but I think it's going to be dependent on table cooperation. I get the notion of wanting to emphasize the arms race that is Relics, but at the same time, I'm iffy about the results. Relics is a story game. This is both a good thing and a bad thing. On the good, it makes for an easy barrier to entry, since it's not as crunch intensive. On the other hand, it's still asking a lot from the players and GM's narrative abilities. compared to the traditional approach. Some can do it, others are going to need a little bit of goading. And as much as I like the system present, I do think its biggest issue is presentation. Not in a layout sense, but in a sense of being unable to summarize some of its mechanics. I think an appendix or a cheat sheet was needed that sums up character creation in one page, tests in one page, relics in one page, etc. The appendix on names and some of the lore is nice, but it could use some more. There's a very kitchen sink vibe with this approach. Despite being a narrativist game, I would not exactly recommend this game to newcomers, since I think it's asking for everyone to be on the same page regarding what it's doing, i.e. your enjoyment is going to live and die on the group's ability to play off of each other. All things considered, I would put Relics, A Game of Angels down with a stamp of caution. If that sounds low, keep in mind that caution doesn't mean it's bad, merely that the game is going to demand a specific type of player base and not everybody is going to fit that player base. Narrativist games are the poster children for your mileage may vary, and this is no exception.